Hi everybody.
Parashat Bahaalotcha. This amazing parasha talks about the menorah, the special lamp that was in the Mishkan, the tabernacle, and later on in Beit HaMikdash, in the Holy Temple in Jerusalem. And I want to take you to a special book. It's called Zohar Tehillim. This book gives you an explanation, according to the secret, about the book of Psalms. Now in the book of Psalms, you have chapter 67 that talks about the menorah. We read this chapter during our daily prayers. And I want to read to you a little bit from the part that is called Menorah Teorah. והשבעה פסוקים מן המזמור הזה, דע כי שבעה פסוקים מן המזמור הזה, רומזים לשישה קצוות העולם, שהם מזרח, מערב, צפון, דרום, שמיים וארץ, והקדוש ברוך הוא אדון ומלך על כל This explains to you about the directions of the world. East, west, south, north, heavens and earth, and God above everything, and from the center, give his sustenance to everybody. וזה הפסוק רומז ליום השביעי שהוא השבת, ומעלתו קדושתו על ששת ימי המעשה. Another secret that we have is about the Sabbath that gives you also the sustenance and is above the other 6 days of the week. And the secret of it, that it gives you a true connection to the tree of life that is in heaven. וכן רומז לקדוש ברוך הוא שממנו באה האורות והברכות וההצלחות לכל העולם. So God gives the sustenance and all the blessings to the world. וכמו כן, ארץ ישראל היא הקנה האמצעי, וירושלים הוא הנר מן הקנה האמצעי, ובית המקדש הוא האור המתפשט ונוצץ. So, the land of Israel is the center candle, and above it, on the top of it, is Jerusalem. And from that, the light that comes out is actually from the Holy Temple. And this whole light goes to the whole world. And that's why the land of Israel and Jerusalem and the Holy Temple are so important to the sustenance of the world.
The menorah was built from one whole piece. One, not parts by parts. It was all one big part. And when Hashem talks to Moshe and he wants him to build it, Moshe doesn't get it. How can you build something that is so united, that it's just one? And he literally needs Hashem's directions to really explain how to do it. Because the unity that Hashem was asking Moshe to put into the menorah is a unity that needs to be in our universe. But because our universe is so mixed with chaos everywhere, it's very hard for us to really, really believe and understand that there could be a different way. And the only way to get to it is to be truly united with God. And that unity can help you. When you feel one with God, you really see that everything around you is all God's creation. And that we are here to protect the garden. And when we really understand that, we know that we have to really dedicate our lives to spread unity between people. Because we were all created in God's image. And when we are in this garden, and instead of spreading love and unity, we spread hatred and we spread all this negativity, we just destroy this amazing garden that was given to us to protect. So this is our job this week, not just this week, every day. Also, in the beginning of the parasha, it says that Hashem talked to Moshe and told him to talk to Aaron. And then it says that Aaron did what Moshe said to him to do. Now wait a minute. Aaron is a high priest, Kohen Gadol. He's very elevated. He knows everything, right? Why does he have to listen? Why does the Torah highlight that he listened and did exactly what Moshe said? This is a very big, you know, lesson about, first of all, the humbleness that Aharon had. And also because Aharon was so elevated, he was connected directly to the light. And he knew that Moshe is giving him the words from heaven, the words from God, and that he has to listen. Aharon was not just lighting the candles and putting the incense for himself or for that moment. He was planting the seeds to all the generations that are coming. He knew that his job is so powerful and so important that he cannot let his ego go in, he cannot let any negativity go in. And not only that, what he planted, this menorah, and the power that was in it, is connecting us all the way to Hanukkah, and all the way to the way that the world is moving today. All the seeds of that love that Aharon and Moshe, and of course God, left for us all the way from the Mishkan, and later on the Holy Temple, and even today, this is something that is affecting the whole world. But the Torah highlights the part that Aharon did it. Why? Because this parasha wants to teach us about how the negative forces work on us. So first of all, Aharon did what Moshe said. But look at the nations, right? Look at the Israelites. They've seen the 10 plagues. They've seen all the miracles. They went out of Egypt. They went and crossed the Red Sea. They ate the manna. And still, they didn't stop arguing with Moshe. And they didn't stop, you know, complaining all the time. The dark side is very, very strong. And a lot of times when we hear someone telling us what to do, and it's the right thing, it's the right thing, but it doesn't really, it's not so comfortable for us to do it. And it kind of contradicts our desire to ourselves alone, and we all have it. There are two steps that we can recognize that the dark side is, you know, putting the arsenal, putting the poison in, the venom in, and we can recognize it thanks to this parasha. Number one, it would make us feel that we know everything. Oh, I don't need to listen to you. I know everything. We're all like that, right? That's what a lot of times they did to Moshe. And if that doesn't work, because you know that, yeah, this was the right thing. So then you go and find a flaw, something bad about that person. Because if I find something bad in that person, I don't need to listen to them. This is the way the dark side is putting the spell on us. We have to work on that. We have to be aware of it. And we have to fight it. Now, in this parasha also, in chapter 10, verse 35, we have something very, very unique. It's the letter Nun. There are actually two Nuns that are starting a sentence, the pasuk, and finishing it, and they're upside down. Now, the letter Nun represents in Hebrew Nefila. It's the first letter in the word falling. And here, it's actually upside down, so it's like it's protecting us from falling. And the sentence in that verse is the part that we're saying when we're about to read, before we start to read the Torah on Saturday morning or on holidays. And that's the part, Vayhi b'nso Aharon v'yomer Moshe. So that special sentence is very powerful. And when it comes with those two Nun to help us to uplift ourselves, and gives us another extra strength to fight the dark side.
Regarding the falling, each and every person in life has hard times and faith. Even Moshe Rabbeinu, Big Moses, had problems sometimes with faith. The people wanted sometimes to kill him. They came to him with all their problems and to do this and to do that. And Moses, you're bad. Why did you bring us here? Why did you do that? And it was very hard for him, and he always looked up to God and say, God, please help me. And God is always there, and we need to remember that God is always with us, and God loves us. And Sometimes it's really hard to see that. We just need to believe. And God is there. He's not leaving us alone. Ever. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.